Hello, my dear students. Welcome to CMI's online classes. In today's class, for the students of Standard 6, we will continue with Chapter 9 of our English grammar, that is, the simple tenses. The simple tenses are further divided into three types according to the time reference of the actions that take place during different times. So, in our previous two videos on the same chapter, we understood simple present tense in the first video and simple past tense in the second video. And in this video, we are going to understand the simple future tense. So, in this video, we are going to understand simple future tense and what kinds of actions are expressed in this simple future tense and what is the sentence structures of this simple future tense. So, let us see what is written about the simple future tense here in the book. It is written here, the simple future tense in English is used to describe an action that will happen in the future. Immediate or on-the-spot decision, intentions, promises, predictions, without evidence. So, इसका मतलब है, simple future tense is used to describe. Simple future tense में हम कैसे कामों को describe करेंगे? Is used to describe an action that will happen in the future, जो भविष्य में होने वाले हैं. Immediate भविष्य में जो बहुत जल्द होने वाले हैं और ऑन द स्पॉट डिसीजन और अबाउट द डिसीजन ऑफ द एक्शंस दैट हैव बीन प्लान्ड टू बी टेकन इन द कमिंग डेज इंटेंशंस व्हाट एवर इंटेंशंस वी हैव मेड अबाउट द प्लान्स अबाउट द एक्शंस टू बी टेकन प्लेस इन द कमिंग डेज प्रॉमिसेस What promises about the work, about the action we have made to do in coming days? Predictions. What is the possibilities of action that will be taken place in future, in coming days? But without any kind of evidence. We will not know that such actions will take place certainly or not. But we are hopeful about the actions that will take place. Okay. So, in totality, we have to understand that all those actions that will take place in coming days, it may be coming immediately, okay, or after some times. That means the decisions have been taken about the actions to be taken place, but yet not the action has been taken. It will be taken in coming days. Okay, all those intentions, promises, predictions, possibilities of actions that has to be that have to be taken in coming days. So those kind of actions are expressed in simple future tense. So, as I have told you that about the classification of tenses, there are four classifications of tenses, like simple tenses, in which we have in this chapter about the simple tenses. Okay, we have continuous tenses, we have perfect tenses, and we have perfect continuous tenses. So, today, when we are learning about simple future tense, we have to understand what is the sentence structure of simple future tense. So, simple future tense. As I have told you that whatever the future tenses we have, like simple future tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, okay, or future perfect continuous tense. So, all these tenses are framed with the help of the modal auxiliaries will or shall. Okay. So, here also in simple future tense also we use will or shall with the main verb. Okay. सो विल और शैल, विल और शैल क्या है? विल और शैल आर द मॉडल ऑक्सिलरीज, और वी कैन से द मॉडल वर्ब्स. सो दीज आर यूज, दीज मॉडल वर्ब्स विल और शैल आर यूज एज द हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स इन सिंपल फ्यूचर टेंस. ओके, सो विल और शैल आर यूज एज द हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स विद द मेन वर्ब्स इन सिंपल फ्यूचर टेंस टू एक्सप्रेस द फ्यूचर एक्शंस. सो वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इन ऑल फ्यूचर टेंसेस वी हैव टू यूज विल और शैल टू एक्सप्रेस द फ्यूचर एक्शंस. दैट मीन्स विदाउट विल और शैल वी डू नॉट फ्रेम एनी फ्यूचर टेंसेस. ओके, सो हियर एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट आफ्टर यूजिंग मॉडल्स व्हेन द सिंगल वर्ब कम्स, व्हेन द मेन वर्ब्स कम, द मेन वर्ब्स आफ्टर द मॉडल ऑक्सिलरीज आर ऑलवेज v1. सो आफ्टर विल और शैल ऑल्सो वेन एवर वी आर यूजिंग द मेन वर्ब दैट आर ऑलवेज v1. सो इन सिंपल फ्यूचर टेंस we use will or shall before the main verbs. Okay, that means after the subject. After the subjects, we use will or shall as the helping verbs. And after these helping verbs, will or shall, which are the modal auxiliaries, we use main verbs. And as I've told you, after modal auxiliaries, we always use v1. So after will or shall, we use v1. That means in future, in simple future tense, we use v1 as the main verbs, whether the subject is singular or plural. Okay, so in general, the sentence structure of the simple future tense is subject plus will or shall plus v1. Now after will or shall, v1 plus rest of the sentence. So this is the structure of sentence in future simple future tense when the sentences are affirmative. Okay, now if you want to make a change this sentence into negative, we have to add not after will and shall. Okay, if will or shall are used as the helping verbs here, then when we change the same sentences into interrogative, as I've told you, when we make question sentences by using helping verbs, that means those helping verbs are used at the beginning of the sentences. Okay, and the subject comes between those helping verbs and the main verbs. Okay, let us see how to frame the affirmative sentences in simple future tense, the negative sentences in simple future tense, as well as interrogative sentences in simple future tense. But before that, we will understand the uses of the simple future tense. Okay, we use will plus verb, will or shall plus verb. Okay, so here only will is written, but we also use shall. Okay, now here it is written, simple future tense is used to talk about actions that are not planned. Okay, not actually planned, but will take place in coming days. The speaker decides to the action at the time of speaking. Okay, so the actions are not planned. Matlab, जो भी काम होने वाले हैं उस काम के बारे में हमने कुछ प्लान नहीं बनाया है, लेकिन उसे हम डिसाइड करेंगे उस एक्शन के बारे में बोलते समय. ओके, लाइक आई विल हेल्प यू डू योर होमवर्क इफ यू गिव मी सम ऑफ योर आइसक्रीम. सो आई विल हेल्प यू, ही हैजंट हेल्प हिम, सो ही विल हेल्प हिम इफ ही गिव्स हिम सम ऑफ हिज आइसक्रीम. Okay, that means this action has not been taken place, it will take place in future. Okay, now I will see you at the science exhibition tomorrow afternoon. That means this action will be taking place tomorrow. Okay, that means the action has not been taken. Okay, it will take place tomorrow. Okay, so here if you see the subject plus in place of will or shall, we have will and see, P1. Here also subject, will or shall, in place of will or shall, we have will and help, V1. Now, the another point to understand, to predict a future event, for example, matlab, andaza lagana, aane wale din mein kya hone wala hai, kya hoga, uska andaza lagana, aise andaze lagane ke liye bhi hum simple future tense ka istemal karenge. It will rain heavily tomorrow. Prediction. Okay. Your wound will soon fester if you don't see a doctor. So see here, whatever the kind of actions we express in simple future tense, but we always remember that the subject, that the sentence structure is subject plus will or shall plus B1 plus rest of the sentence. It is here subject. It is subject. In place of will or shall, we have will, rain, verb, B1, and heavily tomorrow, rest of the sentence. Okay, your wound. This is subject. In place of will or shall, we have will here. Okay, soon fester. This is B1, and this is rest of the sentence. Understood? Now, another point to discuss what kind of actions to express in simple future tense is to talk about promises or commands. So, जो भी promises हमने किए हैं, so promise हम करते हैं कि हम future में कुछ करेंगे, okay? So such promises are also written or expressed in simple future tense or the commands, orders, okay? For example, I will man this post till you are back. Okay, I will serve loyally and well when I am in the army. Okay, see here. So, we use, what you have understood, these are the promises. Okay, we use not after will to form negative sentences. So, negative sentences, that means sentences with no or not. So, we understood in simple present and simple past also, that means after the helping verbs do, does, did, we use not to make them or change them into negative sentences. Okay, so here we have the helping verb will or shall. So after will or shall, we use not, and again B1 to change the affirmative sentences in simple future tense into negative sentence. Okay, like It will not rain till June now. Okay, so subject plus will or shall plus not plus B1. Okay, I will not share my cake with you. Subject plus in place of will or shall we have not. The main part of negative sentence, share, B1. Okay, and rest of the sentence. So now, structure of structure of sentences in simple future tense. Okay, first one is affirmative, as I've already told you, subject plus will or shall plus B1 plus rest of the sentence. The first structure of sentences which I explained just before. Okay, so like subject plus will or shall also we may use. Okay, base form of the verb means here B1. Okay, rest of the sentence. Now, see, I will meet you at the mall. She will write a letter to the editor. They will help us clear the road. Now, see here, we have to learn how to frame affirmative sentences, negative sentences, and interrogative sentences in simple future tense. Okay, so here from this affirmative sentences, from the structure of affirmative sentences only we will understand this. Okay, like here, see, I will meet you at the mall. So this is positive sentence, that means affirmative sentence, but in simple future tense. Now, if you change this into negative sentence, negative sense, we have to add not after will and before the main verb. So here will is the helping verb here and meet is the main verb. So after helping verb and before main verb we have to use not. That means negative sentence. Negative structure of negative sentence is subject plus will or shall plus not plus be one plus rest of the sentence. See here, I will not meet you at the mall. So this is negative sentence in simple future tense. So after the helping verb will and before the main verb meet, we have used not. So every sentence in the simple future tense can be changed into negative after putting not between the helping verb and the main verb. That means between will or shall and main verb, be1. Okay. Now, interrogative sentences means question sentences. So, question sentences can be framed by using helping verbs or by using WH words. So, here, if we are making question sentences, interrogative sentences by using will or shall, by using helping verbs, so here we have helping verbs as will or shall. So, whenever we are framing question sentences by using helping verbs, the subject comes between the helping verb and the main verb. Like, see here, she will write a letter to the editor. Okay, now, she will write the letter. She will write. So, will is helping verb, write is main verb. Now, the same sentence we will write in interrogative. See, will she write a letter to the editor? This is the interrogative sentence, but in simple future tense. Okay. Now, this is interrogative sentence by using helping verbs, because we have used the modal will as the helping verb here. Okay. Now, here, we can also write this sentence, the same interrogative sentence, by using WH word. So, when we use WH words to write interrogative sentences, we just have to add WH word before the helping verb, and we have to see the sentence and we have to find out the answer word from the sentence. Okay, so here answer word is a letter. We have two answer words here. One is a letter and another is the editor. Okay, so now a letter is noun, so what? In place of a letter, we will write, it gives a sense of what, because it gives a sense of noun. So, editor, to whom? Editor, to the person. So, whom? So, if we remove a letter, we have to place what at the beginning of the sentence before this helping verb. And if we remove the editor, we have to use whom at the beginning of the sentence, and we have to remove the editor. Like, whom will she write a letter to? Okay, whom will she write a letter to? Okay, don't write whom she will write. Okay, question. When we write questions, we have to write helping verbs before the subject. She is the subject here. Okay. So WH word सबसे पहले होगा, उसके बाद helping verb आएगा, उसके बाद subject आएगा, उसके बाद main verb आएगा. Now we have removed the answer word editor. Whom will she write a letter to? Answer is the editor. Or we can also write to whom will she write a letter. Okay. To को हम सबसे पहले भी लिख सकते हैं. Okay. Now if you remove this letter, then we have to write what. Now see, what will she write to the editor? Okay, the answer is a letter. Okay, so I hope you have understood. You have understood framing sentences in simple future tense, whether the sentences are affirmative, negative, interrogative, both with helping verbs and WH words. Okay, if still you have any doubts, kindly keep your doubts, raise your doubts in the class so that I may help you to clarify all your doubts. So this much for today's class, students. Thank you so much.